So guys, I think I don't even want to say it. It might be resolved. One of my regular viewers, Mike, someone, I'm not going to use his last name, was the first one to say it before a few other people said it. He's talking about, what about a code? Have you checked for codes or anything? I go, no. It blew. I didn't have any lights on the dash. It blew. I fixed it. Drove around forever. So we decided, let's just, like me and him talking, let's just reset the map, which is the same thing as resetting the code. You don't need to do the battery or anything. Just reinstall the map, and it relearns all. It resets all the learning, right? Well, so far, on just like 5 minutes of driving, it's worked. Because remember, every time I'd start up, it would jump to 35 fuel every time, right? And it's just a mess. But that time, after resetting, it stayed at zero because it reset, and then after a couple minutes, it starts moving. But it kind of was in the 10 and 10 side. It never went to 35. I have my hopes up, but I've been let down so many times. I'm not convinced yet it's fully fixed, but I think it is. So the biggest questions would be, how could a limp code that is fixed still be affecting the engine? And also, I don't really think it's limp mode specifically. I was reading about that, and limp mode technically is like a flashing engine light, and it's in limp mode. But something similar to that, possibly. Now, I don't know if resetting the ECU is the same thing as if I had just driven it for a while to relearn it after I fixed it. But the issue with that is it wasn't barely drivable. If I just put my foot in the pedal a quarter, half inch, it would bog down. You couldn't drive. I couldn't drive it for 15 minutes and relearn it back. So either the code existing there when I didn't know it was there and clearing it solved it, or else I would have had to maybe drive it a lot in that terrible condition to relearn all that stuff back. Part of the reason it got so screwed up, I think, the hose popped off at least 15 minutes away from my house, and I had to drive 15 long minutes home like that. So it did a lot of learning in that time, also. And maybe it just couldn't learn back as far that deep. It was so screwed. Now, I'm just trying to get a little hope in my mind. Maybe I fixed it. If I did, I can put back all the rest of the. I don't have too much junk left. Oh yeah, I'm not doing any of these freaking shields. No, I mean actually, I'm not doing the radiator shield. Is that back there? Oh, I forgot where it was. My radiator shield is always in the way every time I got to work on it. That's one thing. Oh, there it is. It's because you got to take off the radiator cap to take it off, and I always got to whenever I'm working on the charge pipe, it comes off, and you have to wait for it to get cold in, and it's just honestly, it gets in the way more than it helps. Now, someone had another good idea. I just had an idea. I might just use the left half of that. Well, that might look even dumber. I mean, the stuff with the words on it, and then keep the left side free. But I don't know, that does seem kind of dumb. Anyway, let me stop rattling here. I need my access port. I need my venti. Now that the wife is home, I mean, what a great Mother's Day, right? I mean, she had to work 9 to 1, so she just got home. I was handling the kids. We'll make a nice dinner tonight or something too. So let me just get in the car, and this will be my second drive to see if it's fixed. I fixed it last time, drove, idled for a minute, looked okay, drove for 3 minutes, it still was okay. That doesn't mean it's fixed. So let's take it for a spin. Oh my God, dude, it's like I can hardly breathe in here. I think it's 105. My access port's fogging up. It's so hot in here. Let me start this. Holy Mary, priest, Mother of God, Jesus Christ. Come on. I have to do AC. That's gonna screw up my test. That's all right. That's all right. I have to do AC. Oh. I need AC. Oh my God. or I'm gonna like literally, I might pass out. I instantly start sweating. So far, that's good as far as, you know, you'd be seeing that idol jump everywhere already by now. Now, I mean, it isn't the worst thing in the world, but I don't like that 2-3-4 learning. It's better than negative 35 learning, I guess. Dam is still good. And if this ride goes well and I think it's fixed, I will again put in the DW fuel pump. This is the stock fuel pump. Of course, I took it out because I didn't know if that was all these issues or not. And a lot of people are saying it's super unlikely that you got a bad pump out of the brand new box. So I don't think I didn't get a brand new, I did not get a bad pump out of the box. Okay, that's okay. It's just the AC coming on made it jump a little. That's what it does with a few revs. Right about 10-10, not bad, not bad. All right. Oh my God, I gotta turn a little more AC. It's barely working. Oh, let me close the garage. See if I can spin down. I'll go down some quieter roads. I'm just, you know, I'll be shell-shocked for like a week, even if it's fixed, even if it's fixed. Just like never trusting the car now. You know, my whole trust is gone because I spent like 36 hours on just working on it and just having a nightmare experience. Step on it a little. Picks up pretty nice. It's not bogging down. I'm still just praying. What I don't want, I'm hoping doesn't happen, is that it doesn't change to negative 35 in a bit. Like, and it remembers that it was broke or something. And it's still broke. Is, you know, it could change back to 35, but right here I'd be getting a lot of bucking and bogging, which I'm not getting now, just when I'm barely touching the pedal, like a half inch. And I mean, I'm thinking it's fixed, but on one hand, I don't want to put in the other fuel pump for a few days, or for a day, and complicate things just in case. On the other hand, I want to get everything just done now and seal it back together now that I do think it's fixed and put that behind me. Like, I don't want to still have to deal with a fuel pump job later. I do think it's fixed. I'd always get the hesitation right about at this intersection. I literally remember every time I went out last night, and then I'd do a Yui right there, and I did not really get that hesitation. It was the light throttles were the worst part of the issue. Like, the full throttle, sometimes it would just surge and jump and then pull hard a little bit. But when I just barely touched it is when it would just fall on its face, when I just dabble the throttle a little bit. I can't really reproduce that now. I don't know. Might still be an issue because I do have a negative 19 there now. Not sure if that's what it's doing. Oh, go. There you go. Okay. I mean, I'm kind of getting nervous that the air fuel thing is still growing. I thought I kind of had it, but it's starting to look like maybe I don't. So now my heart is kind of starting to sink.